You're listening to the Time to Kill podcast with your host, Ethan Miles, Connor O'Keane.
Yo.
Guy Clark.
What's up?
And special guest, Katlin O'Keane.
First guest ever.
Hey.
Inaugural guest.
Yeah.
Ignorable guest.
Ignorable guest.
Lucky guest. This is really exciting.
Episode 4 is the ignorable guest.
I don't get excited about it much, though.
No? So yeah. this is cool for you. This is like...
Do you get excited about things often? Do you have much to be excited about?
Not at the moment.
There are some people that...
you're broke as shit.
Some people have nothing to be excited about, but still like,
I get jazzed. Like, I'll be like, ooh, yeah.
Jazzed!
But I'm not like, oh my God! Like, you know, people who like...
Freak out because they got Katy Perry tickets.
Yeah, like, I've never been... Like, even when I heard that I was going to, like, Taylor Swift and John Mayer, I was like, oh, yeah, cool.
Oh, fuck off. When you got John Mayer tickets, you put up on Instagram video being like, John fucking Mayer!
Yeah, because at first I was like, John fucking Mayer, but I wasn't like, oh, my God, like, 65 days to John Mayer, and then, like, counting down or anything. Yeah, I was kind of just
you were like, chill, if John Mayer sees you like this. hey, John Mayer. How are you?
All I got from that whole Jonathan. Thing was John fucking Madden.
John fucking Madden. What we been up to? What have you been up to this week, Ethan?
I went to Costco today.
Yeah, you did too. How was
I got a pizza that was as big as my face. we got a Wii U that's broken. Just found out.
That's all we got was a broken Wii U and pizza. Even like dying
get,
like, pizza.
Candy? Where'd you get the candy from?
I got the candy from a shop on Elizabeth Street.
Oh, Sugar Station.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I didn't want to name names.
name drop Sugar Station.
No, until they start endorsing us, we shouldn't give them any free promotion.
If we ever got like promotion, like got
Guy doesn't need an excuse to eat more sugar.
I always do.
But Guy got extra because he just figured I'd steal all his, and I got stuff for me because I didn't want to steal all of his.
Yeah.
So between us, we had like candy enough for 3 or 4 people.
Yeah.
I said at the start, like when I was shoveling candy, I'm like, just don't buy anything, just eat off mine. He's like, you sure? I'm like, I know you're going to do it anyway. And then he started, and I've already got this whole thing of mixed candy. I'm like, why stop now?
It didn't help that I started filling his with stuff as well. He got one, like, sherbet bomb. I was like, no, that's
some more sherbet bombs.
Some more sherbet bombs, because I want to steal them.
I only got one sherbet bomb, because I already had, like, a kilo of fucking candy.
And literally, the only thing I took from his bag was, I think, like, the strawberry lace.
Yes.
Which he only got 3 of. But he gave one to me.
Yeah, because I got 2 for me. I'm like, I better get one for Ethan.
Yeah.
Because he's going to fucking steal one.
And
I'm going to eat one and want more.
Yep.
And I got this lion bar, which is gone.
You
put it in your bag.
Put it in my bag. Keep that
and
safe.
And explain to the listeners what's
the lion bar. Like,
it's like when you shit in foil and it's got nuts.
It's not the words I'd use.
Exactly.
I'd compare it more to sort of a boost bar.
Right.
And then you break it in half and it looks like a lion roar. You don't have to make the sound effect.
Yeah.
But I find it tastier if you do. It's like, oh, I've got that in my bag because I don't want
to. Why don't you do it now?
Yeah.
And show the viewers.
The listeners will be like, I want a lion bar.
I'm literally on the verge of a diabetic coma. And if I break it open, I'll have to eat it and I'll die.
Okay.
Yeah. I've recently discovered that I have an addiction.
To?
Sugar.
Okay. Yeah.
like, no, because meth's one of those, like, you look good on meth.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what? Meth addicts.
Yeah.
Fluke.
It doesn't affect your teeth. You know how you always see meth addicts with, like, yellow teeth and shit? That's just because they do so much meth, they don't have time to brush their teeth.
Wow.
It's not like, because a sugar addiction would fuck your teeth up.
My teeth
I should
like
pick up meth, because I've got nothing to worry about.
Yeah. Well, like, I know a thing or two about fucked up teeth being British. So looked up the drugs I can do. I do a shit ton of meth. You wouldn't know.
So you're saying
that? Yeah, I'm definitely a sugar. Like with, you know how people kind of be like, okay, I'll have one candy.
Yeah.
I won't stop until I hate myself.
Yeah.
Until I'm like sitting there like sweating, sugar pouring, like seeping out of my pores, being like, why? And like crying.
How did this happen?
Yeah. Like, Jared has to literally stop me, like, hold me down and stop me from eating.
Let go of me! I'll fucking kill you! I think you've had enough.
You had enough. Like, I get really angry.
I'll tell you when I've had enough.
I want the old Katlin back. I want sugar free.
Katlin Zero. No,
what's
Katlin
for dinner?
Katlin Zero. Coke Zero and Diet Coke.
Yeah.
Almost exactly the same thing.
Yeah.
But Coke Zero is just marketed towards men.
Yeah, because yeah, I see Diet Coke. If I see Diet Coke, I'm just like, fuck that shit. If I see Coke Zero, I'm like, zero, that's got a Z in it.
Yeah. Like, yeah, no, that's, yeah.
Yeah, because I'm like, I don't know what the fuck black. The actual that's difference
black.
Is.
And it's black.
I only know old people that drink Diet Coke and like one friend.
Right? I see, I won't drink regular Coke.
You're fucked.
Yeah.
Yeah. Get what out. Did I just have? You Pepsi just Max? Pepsi.
You just had Pepsi, normal Pepsi.
Oh my god.
Oh, it begins.
Sorry, quick, calm me down. Yeah.
I don't know if I've got any, like, addictions. Not like proper addictions, you know, yeah. People are like, oh, I'm addicted. You know, those joking addictions. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I don't really have any of those.
Yeah. I lately have been eating way too much. Or like, just not caring that I'm just eating like, way too much.
Like, just only for the last 22 years.
Like, you know how when I was really little, I used to eat so much and then I'd throw up? Yeah. And then Dad would be like, you have to stop this. And I'm like, I'm out of control. And I was like 5.
Yeah.
Yeah, I grew out of that and now I'm back into that. Like, I'll literally just eat food until I'm like feel sick.
Yeah.
And like the meal isn't over when I'm full.
Yeah.
It's the meal is over
when I want to kill myself. Like,
there are some, I think, like some cats and some dogs, you have to measure their food out because they'll literally eat until their stomach explodes.
That's me.
You should just like, your dad should just start feeding you a cup full of kibble every day.
Like if somebody, like I don't mind the occasional cigarette, if somebody said to me, Katlin, this is killing you, stop smoking, I'd be like, okay. But if somebody said, Katlin, stop eating, this is killing you, I'd be like, no!
The whole like, food is good for you, the body needs food.
Stop eating cigarettes.
But yeah, so that's
right on.
Please
yeah,
my door.
Speaking of like eating and bizarre shit, Guy is currently eating an entire pizza.
Guy just put the whole pizza in the microwave and turned the microwave on.
Yeah,
like
I bought the pizza spares yesterday.
It cooks from outside in, yeah.
Yeah.
So the middle's going to be cold, and the outside's going to be too hot.
It's just a cheese pizza, though. Like I don't think there's less chance of him getting like real sick off that shit.
Because I don't obviously microwave a whole fucking pizza. But if I'm cooking a slice or three in the microwave.
Yeah.
Seven.
A slice or three.
Like, I'll put it in for a minute. Slice or seven. I'll put it in for a minute, and every 20 seconds I'll alternate the slices.
I see, I'm not that dedicated. I'll just cook it. I'll just nuke it until the whole thing is like.
I'm the only one.
Really hot. Fucking hot.
I'm the only
hot,
one here
yeah.
being like Rain Man of their pizzas.
Yeah.
Gotta rotate after 20
so
seconds.
So, what was that knife thing that you were saving for the podcast?
Oh, yes. We okay. met.
We're going to stab set the scene. You in the forehead.
What
we
happened?
Met a delightful folk. On the
477 bus to Broadmeadows. Yeah,
shout
we're on
out
the bus.
To the bus over.
Standard.
Yep.
Shout out to Broadmeadows. I like knife crime.
So who was there? Set the scene. What kind of day was it?
Well, it was nighttime.
It was
a stormy, sexy night.
Stormy, sexy night yesterday night. We're on the bus. We get on and it's me, Ethan, Caitlin, Chris.
Yeah, Dream Team,
yeah. And
oh.
This charming fellow in, what was it, football, he, yeah. like soccer kind of top?
Almost completely bald,
except for a fucking
rat tail.
Oh, fuck
you didn't mention
charming rat tail, yeah.
Really?
He gets on and immediately me and Ethan, I can feel Ethan seeing his rat tail and wanting to make fun of it. I'm so glad he didn't, because about 20 seconds later, he pulls out a box cutter and starts, like, just carving shit into the back of the chairs.
He was sat right in front of Chris.
Yeah,
as well.
Right in front of Chris.
I was like, Chris, just
did not give
on,
a fuck.
Over here. Well, no, I think she
Where's
didn't
Chris
want to attract
from?
His attention.
No, I mean, the guy didn't give a fuck.
Oh, right.
Mm. Chris is from Glenroy.
So she's used to it.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Mean
she's
streets,
like, what, is this a guy with a box kind of carving up a bus? You know what I call this in Glenroy? Tuesday.
But, yeah, just started hacking away at this thing. Nothing, like, artistic, nothing.
No, not
no,
even
like,
his name.
Not even, you know... fucking Darren was here or anything.
Steve-O
was here. It was just hacking away at it.
Yeah.
And I was like, whew. I went into fight or flight mode. I was ready to throw
flight.
You guys
you
to the real walls. I was going to fucking just run.
Yeah.
Because
that shit doesn't happen
in Nidri. There'll be a man there holding
with
a shotgun.
Yeah.
Yeah, Nidri's a nice area.
Nothing goes
nothing,
wrong in Nidri.
No, our suburb is great. It's literally just like
old people
old
and
Polish
families.
Women and
except
families
the,
and shit.
Yeah.
Except for the fucking bikers that own the cafes.
Oh, fucking Sam's Cafe is literally ran by disgust. I think if you are in a biker gang... Your
I
parents
don't,
are either...
allowed to talk. I don't want to wake up with a horse's head in my mouth.
No, let me say this. I want to say it.
I'm going to roll here.
If you're in a biker gang, your parents are either brother or sister.
Mum is our sister.
Or you're a fucking cunt. Like, I've never met a nice bikey. And I've never, like, in fact, if you are in a biker gang, you have a small dick.
Okay.
So that's
straight up,
a small dick. I just want to point this out at this point. Kat does not represent the O'Keane family, the O'Keane tribe. Yeah, so she does. You're going to come after us, just get me.
Yeah. I do represent the worst parts of my parents.
But also, problem here, right? I don't know what's wrong. You live in the same house.
Yeah.
So if you are going to firebomb the house, mm-hmm. just wait till Connor's gone.
Yeah.
Connor works at Blockbuster Cinema on like Tuesdays.
I bomb Blockbuster.
And I think Catelyn's home most days.
Yeah.
Hmm. At the moment.
At the moment. Got no fucking job. I lost my job.
Yeah. How'd that happen?
Okay.
Where'd you leave it?
Well, she knows where it is. She's not allowed to do
I was working at Baker's Delight selling donuts to fat cunts. And Shout out to Baker's.
I buy donuts from that store.
Also, selling bread to my mom. So.
And your brothers.
And your brothers. Your brothers are so scared about everything.
I'm bringing me free bread.
Yeah, and I would give people free bread, like make it rain bread slices. Yeah, bitch, get it.
See, I had this nice image of you doing like a kind of Disney, like bread for everyone. Yeah. You've turned it into a fucking Iggy Azalea clip.
First things first, on the really
brown paper bag with baguette sticking out, and she's spinning around and throwing it.
Yeah.
But she's just not. She's like, "You want this bread?
You can dance for it. Who baked that?
Get this bread out of my cold dead hand."
Anyway, I got a hand infection on my hands, obviously.
Yep, obviously.
Fuck. I feel you edging away from me, Ethan. Fuck you.
Give him a cuddle.
I don't want to get fired. Shut the fuck up. I got some leave from work, and then they just never called me back. And then I called one of my bosses, and I was like, "Hey, do I still have a job?" And he said yes. But then his wife called me and was like, "No." And then a tattoo. So I don't have a fucking
Baker's
job. Delight.
More like Baker's distraught. Because I lost my job.
I like Baker's.
You should have said that to him. Yeah.
I like Baker's Delight even more now. I know my bread doesn't have scabies on it.
Fuck you. Yeah, so.
That's fucked.
Yeah, and I've been going to Centrelink.
Giving them scabies.
How's that? There's always stories at Centrelink. No?
Oh, actually, I was there yesterday. And a guy lost his poop.
I was going to say, we've literally been saying cat and bikey's got small dicks. And you're just like, he's lost his poop.
Doo-doo. Yeah, he flipped out.
What about?
He was on the phone. And it's relatively quiet in Centrelink. Like, everyone kind of just minds their own business. And he was on the phone in Centrelink. And he just flipped out and he's like, "What the fuck did you say?" And he's like, "What's your fucking name?" And then the guy on the phone was like, "Wayne." He's like, "Wayne what?" And he flipped out. And
Wayne Brady.
And he just lost his shit.
Jesus.
Which is very understandable because I almost lost my shit at Centrelink. It's just soul crushing. Like, every time I go in there,
I'm
majority of the time thinking about how I'm going to kill myself. And so far...
No?
Really?
Oh, Jesus.
Holy shit.
Jesus.
I've lived a privileged life. I've never even seen the inside of something.
Every time.
And so far, I've come up with, I'm going to get really drunk.
Oh, God.
I'm going to make a bathtub. Shut up, let me finish.
Make a bathtub.
I'm going to build a bath. I'm going to fill it with water. I'm going to take a bath, hopefully drown, in a tempered pool of my own piss and soothing bath salts.
Oh. No, wait. Because, just playing off the Baker's Delight theme, bring a toaster in the bathtub with you.
Oh.
Ooh.
And then you can make the people that fired you feel guilty because it's their fault.
Yeah, I'm going to leave a note.
Use their bread as well.
Use their bread, yeah.
The toast.
Yeah.
That's good.
That's good. That is good. If it's anything, it's good.
I'm not telling you to kill yourself.
Obviously,
you are. God, no. I'm not one of these people. Like some days, like, I'm not one of those sad people who think about death. I'm like a cheery death person.
Yeah.
Because I'll be like, "Is anyone else thinking about killing themselves?" All my friends are like, "Oh, Kat, you can't say that. Oh my god."
And you're like, "What? What's the problem? Think about killing myself all the time."
But it's not because I'm sad. It's just because I'm really, this is what life is. Because as far as I can see, it's only downhill from here. Because eventually you got to have kids.
You don't have to.
Well, what the fuck else am I gonna do? Like, I'm literally mum, because when I said to mum, I go, mum, do you even like your kids? And she's like, nah. No. I have kids, and she goes, what else was I supposed to do? Oh. I remember thinking, that's a bit fucked, but now I'm turning into that.
My mum always tells us, she's like, I should have just got some fucking newts. As I watched, like, I like newts.
She's like, kids. She's there in the hospital with like 3-4 fucking kids, whatever, how many of you are?
Six.
You weren't born at the
same
time, were you?
Jesus, that's a lot of
six.
Children.
Yeah.
How are you not on
like, whole, like with all these kids around, she's like, newts. It was newts I like. Fuck. Garrett.
Not newborns.
That's why I'm starting on fucking fish.
Yeah, true.
See how you
dig fish and then maybe upgrade to kids.
I can't put kids in a fucking 12-foot tank.
Yeah.
It's all downhill.
I'm the same when it comes to like thinking about death and stuff. I used to be like scared of dying and shit. Now I'm kind
of
like...
No. I'm scared of the people...
I'm more scared that I've got to find something to do until I die. Because I'm not going to kill myself. I've got too much cool shit going on, but...
I don't think I'd kill myself because I'm sad. I think I'd just be like, are you fucking kidding me? Like the other day, I was like,
kid,
what
you
want to
see a dead body?
And then my friend's like, oh, you know, when life gives you lemons. And I was like,
kill
no!
yourself.
Yeah,
life gives you lemons.
Kill yourself like, with the lemons.
But it is a little tragic that you're sat in Centrelink with scabies thinking, this is the high point of my life. After this, it's just downhill.
Yeah, like, do you not see it getting any better for you?
I don't.
No. I understand that it could, but I always expect the worst.
Right.
So when something nice happens,
I'm
like,
prepared,
oh, that's nice.
I think.
Yeah, like, I do expect any day now for everything to just go crashing down.
What, this empire you've built of scabies and Centrelink to just come falling down? You're like, no, my kingdom.
Pretty much, yeah. Because, I mean, it can only really go down, can it?
No,
I mean,
it can go up, sorry.
Yeah, but it won't because that doesn't happen. It doesn't seem to happen.
No?
No, I really don't think it's going to...
What about the Janoskians?
What about the Janoskians?
No, the Janoskians is why I want to kill myself.
Yeah, honestly, I'm at my fucking...
Because they're talented.
Yeah, I'm at my angriest when I think about those fucking people who are like, who are just... fucking assholes, and they've gotten somewhere at something I really want to get somewhere in. It's just like, fuck.
Yeah, they're one of the people that make me like, I don't get really angry about anything. I get peeved. Like, I'll be like, oh, cunt.
I usually try to be like, if I see, like, some cunt on YouTube or whatever doing really well, and they're just doing fucking being quirky, I'm just like, oh, whatever. There's a market for that, you know, whatever. But the Janoskians, like, fuck off, really?
Yeah, I know.
They're just arrogant little turds.
Yeah, they're the type of people who I'm like,
They're the kind of kids you see them in high school, like, fucking slacking off and not doing their work and disrupting the class.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
You think, I hate you so fucking much, I can only take solace in the fact that you'll get nowhere. You'll get a fucking trades job or something, which is nothing wrong with that, but that's pretty much... Trades
got the
loadies. You'll be fucking fixing toilets or some shit and getting pissed on the weekend. Like, that's all you'll...
I'll be working at Blockbuster.
And at the moment, it's flipped around. I'm stuck at fucking Blockbuster,
and
these cunts are being flown around the world, literally just being flown around the world to be cunts.
You
should have paid attention in school.
Well, the thing is, they say psychopaths have a better time getting ahead because they don't care about the way they treat other people.
Mm.
Like, they got no problem shitting all over people, and they're very good at being manipulative.
Mm-hmm.
So you often find like business people and like executives are just like, sociopaths.
Yeah.
Mm. And I'm here like, oh well, at least I'm not, you know, in fucking Israel.
Yeah.
But then some days I'm like, no, I'd rather be in fucking Israel right now. Like, this is too much.
At least it's warm. Yeah.
All right, okay, hang on, we're doing questions.
Okay, Jared Misson says, discuss your most awkward, embarrassing moment which occurred in a public place.
Okay.
May I start?
Yeah, go ahead.
With one that happened just a few weeks ago, because I mean, a lot of embarrassing shit happens to me on a day-to-day basis,
but this is the one
that I thought, oh my God, are you fucking kidding me? It wasn't that embarrassing, but it was like, oh shit.
Like, oh fuck, this wouldn't happen in Israel.
Yeah. I thought, this is not very sickening.
Okay, yeah. This is not season 6 sickening.
Yes, mama, yes. Okay. I was at Blockbuster.
Yeah, cool.
And I was, like, looking... my bitch. And I was looking at different movies to rent.
Yeah.
And Jared was next to me, but then he walked away. and an old guy was actually next to me, but I thought it was Jared, and so I've like linked arms with him, leant against his chest, and gone, "Oh, I love Rachel McAdams. She's fucking flawless."
And the old guy like Rachel.
And then I look up, and it's this old guy.
It's this fat old guy. I know it's the guy you're talking about.
Fat old guy just staring at me, and he's like, oh. And I'm like, "Oh my god, I'm so sorry. I thought
you were flawless."
Like, I thought you were my boyfriend. And then I walked around and found Jared, and he's like, "What?" I'm like, we have to go now. We had to run out of the shop because I was really embarrassed.
I was working that night. You came up like pissing yourself to the at the desk.
To the desk.
Piss yourself at the desk. That's the second most embarrassing thing I've ever done.
She's like, "Guess what just happened?" And as she's telling me, the guy who she did it to like kind of waddles up behind
her.
And
they're like, "I'm so sorry."
He's like, "It's all right, love. It's
come on, Tiffany's like, "Do you have any movies starring Rachel
McAdams?" I hear she's flawless. Yeah. So that was something that recently that I was like, fuck.
Guy's going to have to skip this question because he just has no shame. I know. Whenever I think of like most embarrassing thing to happen to me, it was when I turned up to a school uniform day, like casual clothes day, a week early.
And were you wearing your Dennis the Menace hat that wobbles?
Oh my god.
I was not. It was a costume thing, fictional character. But luckily for me, I was like, my fictional character is a spy and he's undercover, so I just wore casual clothes. But the really like macabre thing was people like, why are you not in uniform? And I was wearing like, just happened to be wearing sort of a dark outfit. I was like, I've got a funeral after school.
Why?
I don't know.
You froze.
Less embarrassing than being like, oh, I got the date wrong for my school uniform.
That's fucked.
I've got a story from a friend that I found funny.
Yeah, go.
When she was younger, she was like in grade 2 or something. Mm. She was sitting in class and she really needed to pee. And so she was like to the teacher, she's like, "Hey, can I pee?" And the teacher was like, "No, you should have gone at recess." You know how they do that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so rude. Anyway, what if you got a fucking urinary
tract infection?
Yeah. Even though
they can't
too
stop you, though. Like, if you got up to go to the toilet and they're like, "No!" they can't, like, hold you in your seat while you're trying to get up like, to go to the toilet.
They're, like, holding you down, like, you're struggling and shaking. They're like, "Go on. Piss yourself.
Make my day."
I'm not cleaning it up.
Anyway, so she's like, "Miss, I really need to pee." And the teacher's like, "No, you should have gone to recess." And so she's like, "Oh!" And she like can't hold it. So she runs out.
Yeah.
And like midway through the corridor, when she's running to the toilet, she pissed herself. But was too like embarrassed to go and
you know,
to back to the class and say that I pissed myself. And so she told the teachers that there was an old man walking around the school who was pissing on all the children. And told that to the principal. And the principal was like, "Where is she?" Looking around for this old man.
Where's the pisser?
Jesus. Looking around for this old man who's pissing on the little children.
Did she ever get found out?
No.
That's amazing.
If I was like running and I pissed myself, I'd just keep running. I'd never stop. Start a new life somewhere.
Still with piss on your pants.
He came into town with a bindle and piss on his pants.
He's been running.
Oh man.
Yeah, that made me laugh so hard.
I did. I pissed myself in prep. In like, you know, the
in preparation for this podcast.
I needed to go to the bathroom, but I was playing on the computer or whatever, so I left the last minute. Pissed myself just as I got to the bathroom. Just walked back into class and just decided to pretend I didn't. I go, "Yeah."
"You smell, all right, Connor?" "Yeah, I'm fine. How are you?"
The smell and the like giant piss stain is what gave me away. But yeah, that was 5-year-old Connor.
Oh, I got left in a shop once. I just walked off and turned around and my parents went there. That was pretty embarrassing.
My dad left me in a bookshop. We were on the way to Halls Gap. We used to go to Halls Gap for holidays and shit, family holidays. And we'd stop in Ballarat, and there was a bookstore there one time. And I was like looking at fucking Garfield or some shit. I was just like looking at Garfield for about 15 minutes. And then like my dad like runs into the store. He's like, "Oh, thank fuck." I'm like, "What?" And he's like, "We left, we got to the car, and then realized you weren't there." Like, what the fuck?
Yeah, I've been left at shops before. But like, we used to live literally across the street from Safeways.
Yeah.
So like one time, my mum just opened the door, and I'm there. She's like, "What?" I say, Oh, Dad walked off and left me a sandwich. I was like 8 years old.
Guy, embarrassing stories, public.
I can't really think of anything, to be honest.
Remember before you had no shame?
No.
It's far too long ago.
Okay, how about stories that you should be embarrassed by?
Ejected in the street, like, every day at schoolies.
Yeah.
What? Okay, so, yeah, on schoolies, and I was polite. This is how I found out about that him.
So on schoolies,
this is a jacking it story.
Is jack meaning
jacking it means like jerking off?
Yeah.
So like on schoolies, I feel like everyone made an effort to not jerk off on schoolies,
and I did too, not in the house.
Well, yeah, guys, I didn't do it in the house. I'm like, that's really nice. And then, like, a few months later.
How long was schoolies?
Well, that's the thing.
A few months later, I was mentioning to someone else, I was like, oh, guy didn't jack it on schoolies. And guy's like, yeah, dude. I'm like, but you didn't do it in the house. He's like, no, I didn't. No. He waltzed out into the streets and jerked off.
He waddled into the
streets. He waddled into the streets with his pants around his ankles, just like,
I
laughed so hard I cried when you told me that. But I was
mainly did it at the beach.
That's not better.
In the ocean. It's like families there.
During the day.
It's so good. No, there was
like, serve, serve. Money shot to the face. Knocks him off his board.
Jellyfish.
It was like the middle of the night. There was like this really thick bush path and shit like that.
Yeah.
A really sexy bush path.
Yeah, really sexy.
I couldn't help myself.
Why were you like, why? Because like, had you just, because you were on school, he's fun. That guy slept under the stairs. There was a cupboard under the stairs, and he was like, "I'm gonna be Harry Potter."
Just no, like, I didn't.
I'm the boy who lives.
Not once did I ever say Harry
no,
Potter.
You didn't. You missed a golden opportunity there.
We slept in the garage.
I'm trying to think of like embarrassing stories that happened in public for me. I can't think of anything. Okay, I got one that it's not very funny. It just makes me feel like an asshole. I was on the bus with Ethan one time.
Wait.
Yeah, and we were talking about gravity. And I couldn't remember Sandra Bullock's name.
No, you kept saying
I thought it was Susan Sarandon. I thought Susan Sarandon was Sandra Bullock. And Ethan was like kind of laughing and being like, no, it's not Susan Sarandon. I'm like, and because he was smiling because I was a fucking idiot, I thought he was taking the piss out of me. So I got really angry and kind of heated and was like, you're fucking with me. You're fucking with me right now. It's fucking Susan Sarandon, dude. And ended up pretty much shouting so the whole bus could hear me, making a tit out of myself. And then we Googled it, and it was
Sandra Bullock.
I almost said Susan Boyle.
Why ran it in? Oh, God, why?
I'm stuck in space. take her helmet off. George Clooney.
I'd pay money to see Susan Boyle in space.
I'd pay money to see George Clooney is Susan Boyle in space. I'm Susan Boyle in space.
I dreamed of dream. Sexy.
Yeah, and then Ethan's like, and then I'm like, oh, fuck. And Ethan's immediately like, you were smug there. I'm like, I was smug. I'm sorry. And he's like, everybody in this bus heard you. I'm like, oh, probably not everyone. And then the girl sitting three seats away turns around and goes, I heard you. I was going to say something, but yeah. And Ethan's like, you were smug. And this fucking girl's like, you were smug. I'm like, okay, I'm sorry. And then, fuck, I can't remember how it came about. She's like, yeah, I heard you. I was going to say something. And at the time, we were using bitch as, like, just, like, a kind of...
It was the height of Breaking Bad mania.
Yeah, so we're just, like screaming bitch at everything. And like, so instead of going, ah, shit, I went, ah, bitch.
She didn't hear me.
She didn't hear me. Then Ethan opens his fat fucking mouth and goes...
I remember exactly what I said. I'm like...
You're not endearing yourself to these people by calling them a bitch.
She turns around and is like, did you call me a bitch? I was like, yeah, you did. You really did.
Yeah, and I'm just like... I'm like, no, I said bitch. No, I didn't call you a bitch. And she kind of looked at me and went, you watch yourself. So she kind of obviously was joking. But
you're in.
I felt like such a fucking
tool. If anything, I was in.
Yeah.
Because I'm not the one calling people on the bus, bitch.
Yeah, you're a knight in shining fucking armor,
yeah,
aren't you?
Yeah, I came to her rescue. I'm like, don't call m'lady a bitch.
M'lady?
Don't call my bitch a bitch.
I actually, one time,
you're like, you work for Ethan now, bitch.
I was actually on the bus home from, well, this is when I was in high school.
Yeah.
On the way home with Darcy.
Mm-hmm.
And we're talking about, like, Rose Hill kids and, like, how their faces of shit, like, are just scummy.
Yeah.
Like, the younger ones.
Yeah. Get into Rose Hill.
And then we were talking, we're like, yeah, Rose Hill kids are such pieces of shit. Like, they're so scummy. Like, even, like, UKC kids are shit as well.
Yeah.
But, like the year sevens and stuff, they're just douchey at Rose Hill. Anyway, and then, like, two Rose Hill kids were sitting in front of us and turned around and, like, just stared at me. I'm like, no, not you. You're angels. And Darcy just looks at me and she's like, angels. I'm like, oh,
you're like,
God.
Darcy, shut the fuck up.
My friend Andrew. Hey, Andy. Love you, bitch.
Hi, Andy.
Shouts out to Andy.
Shout out to Andy. And your mum, Ange. She's a doll. Anyway, he says, please discuss that awful feeling when you go into a shop that is full of stuff you like and heaps of neat stuff, but then you... Then all of a sudden you realise you need to poop really bad, so you have to leave.
I read this and I kind of thought, how often is that a severe problem for you, Andy?
Andrew. Yeah.
And honestly, like, how long, like...
He walks into, like...
Yeah, he sees all this fun merchandise and just gets the shit.
He walks into Smiggle and he's like, oh no, not Taco.
I shouldn't have walked around JJ's eating this burrito.
Yeah, how often is that a problem? Because it sounds like it's a recurring thing every time. Yeah, every time he walks into a nice shop, he's just like...
Just triggers the shitting reaction.
He goes into IKEA and he's like, no! Not here.
He runs into the children's ball pit area they've got. And he's like, I'm sorry, kids. Look away.
He runs to the toilet section, but he cannot build one fast enough. Because the instructions are fucking stupid.
He like looks at the sign, the toilet's like, you know, 500 metres away. He's like, oh, no, I'm not going to make it. Looks over and sees the toilets and he's like, I've got to build. Get me an Allen key.
But he's fine walking around Target.
Yeah. He's like this is all tacky bullshit in the fucking JJ. Yeah.
Well, he's still got the shits, but he doesn't care that he's shitting in the store.
He's like, it's just Big W.
Just Tarshay. Tarshay, because I'm a little bit fancy.
Is Andrew a little bit fancy?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
Fierce.
Is he a lot fancy?
He's very fierce. Hey, Andy.
Shouts
out.
He's the one who everything you say is like, yes, Gaga, yes.
Which is the one that said, a sassy day keeps the basics away.
What?
He's so sassy.
He's very sassy.
That's great.
He's lovely, though.
Mm-hmm.
Move on to your topics.
Well, and his dad reminds me of George Costanza's dad from Seinfeld.
Oh, Frank Costanza.
Literally, he is Frank Costanza. Like, and his mum is, what's George's, Estelle.
Yeah.
What am I gonna do with all this papaya? That's his mum. It's my little screeching.
What do they say about? What did he say to his son on the Festivus episode?
So they tell each other how much they don't like.
The airing of grievances.
Yes.
It's so good.
Oh man.
That I feel that is our family Christmas. Every time I have to go to Nan's.
I've stopped going.
I'm gonna stop going because every time I go to see my Nan and Pa, my Pa always tells me how fat I'm getting. Last Christmas, like, I thought I looked nice, and then he goes, fuck, you've put on a bit of blubber, you're like a fucking seal. And
I'm really?
In front of Jared, who had just met them, and in front of cousin Maddie, and he's like size two.
Fuck up, and Jared's like, hey, yeah, you're like a fucking seal.
Yeah. I can't believe I didn't know it. You're over there singing Kiss from a Rose.
It's good, got a bit of seal humour. He's got scary looking scars. He scares me.
Yeah. Baby.
Baby. I'm like, no.
No, stop. I'll put on a bit of blubber.
Well,
we haven't got questions.
Well, your friend wants us to talk about My Chemical Romance.
Carol wants us to talk about
teenagers? Because they scare the shit out of me.
We made that joke like three times yesterday.
It's like the idea that Jared Way is scared of teenagers. And every time he does his concerts to 14-year-old girls, he has to face the other way. Only 40-year-old men can come to my concerts. Jared has spoken. This is the Jared way.
I still dig My Chemical.
Yeah, so do I. What was that album and it had teenagers?
The Black Parade.
Yeah, that was...
That's still a killer album.
Yeah,
And Three Cheers for Sweet Revenge, the one before that.
Yeah.
Play Helena and stuff. That's an awesome album.
Well, Black Parade was like that. Avril Lavigne, her first album.
Let Go, yeah.
Green Day's album, which had like American Idiot. Yeah, yeah,
it was called American Idiot, I think.
Yeah. Oh, fuck, well, I don't know. I was like,
I had Dookie as well.
And
oh yeah,
who else I listen to? And Fallout Boy, I think their first album.
The Cork Tree.
The one with the sheep on the front.
That Infinity on High.
Right. Well, those four albums were like.
That was the first one. First one was Take This to Your Grave.
Yeah, but I love that album from MCR.
Yeah. I think Black Parade was my favorite when I first started listening to them, just because it was kind of accessible.
Even now, when I listen to that album, it's one of those albums. Like,
I can't not listen to it and get kind of pumped.
Yeah, it just makes you want to get naked, like just like.
Well, that's the thing. Like Dad's always like good rock and roll music or good music in general should make you want to fuck or fight. And like it's one of those ones that makes you want to do both. <He's> like, dude, guy's new dance move that he wants to try it next is him like pretending to punch himself in the dick in time to like really heavy music.
Yeah. You just kind of done with the beats, like either alternating fists and the dick and a downward like spot.
So try that out, guys. But yeah, MCR's great. I listened to Gerard Way put out a song, like he's got a solo album coming out.
No way.
Yeah, I listened to it. It's nothing like My Chemical Romance, but it is nice hearing his voice like in something again. Because I really like it.
How many albums do they...
Scared of? The next song's called Iguana's Scared the Living Shit Out of Me.
Iguana's Scared the Living Shit Out of Me.
How many albums do they have?
They've got... Bullets, Three Cheers, Black Parade, and then Danger Days.
Yeah. What did you think of that album?
I dug it. If you're going expecting like Black Parade 2 or Three Cheers 2, you're going to be disappointed. But it's cool as like it was kind of punky like, or pop punk album.
I liked all the. There isn't a song on Black Parade that I don't love. Totally. But like on the later one,
Danger Days. Yeah, there's some songs on there that I kind of I've got to be in a specific mood. Yeah. For. But they're all good songs.
What was their single from that album that they released?
The one that everybody listened to was the No.
Yeah,
no,
when
no,
I first listened to that, I was like, fuck! But like, now I can't listen to it.
I spammed it too much, I think, when I first heard it.
Yeah.
You're listening to Chat Parade, the number one MCR fan podcast.
So what's your friend's name?
Carol.
Well, Caroline. Shout out to Caroline.
Did anyone read the... I think it was Taylor Swift. Taylor Swift took a girl with her to the Academy Awards, and she wrote like her experience being at the Academy Awards and being like a normal person.
Yeah,
it's a really cool read.
That's cool.
Because at the end, she talks about how like she met Harvey Weinstein. Well, she didn't meet Harvey Weinstein. She just like she got tired of the whole Academy Award thing and went to the bar. And there was just this guy, like massive guy, with just like presence drinking at the bar. And he turns to me, he's like, "You know who I am." Goes back to drinking.
That's cool.
I thought you meant he actually had massive presents.
I got these for everyone.
Yeah, that's what I thought you meant. He just turns around. And he's like, and she's like, she's like, those for everyone? No.
You know who I am.
You know who I am.
That's not how we want it. He's not the present kind of guy.
We mentioned this earlier this week, like just in private, in talking and shit. But yeah, Batman, 75 years.
75th anniversary. Well done, Bats.
Yeah, well done.
And you know what? Man.
Well done, Bats everywhere.
Nobody's figured out who's Bruce Wayne yet. Nobody's noticed that Batman is old as fuck and Bruce Wayne is old as fuck. Like, hang on.
So is there like a series that has from when it started to now?
Yeah, well, Detective Comics is the name of the ongoing Batman comic where it got introduced. Like originally it wasn't Detective Comics.
What was that,
Comics.
27?
Yeah.
I think.
It wasn't just like Batman, but... Yeah. Essentially, now it is because Batman's the breakout character.
Mm.
That's still going.
Mm-hmm.
So that's like they rebooted the same. Oh,
they've rebooted
like
the
same
universe and stuff.
Yeah, but like they start the numbering again a bunch of times.
Yeah,
those like they do kind of soft reboots, not as hard as the new 52.
Yeah,
but they do like they start the numbering again when something crazy happens. Mm-hmm. There's all the issue ones, but yeah, Batman's good on him.
What like real quick? What do you reckon? What's your favorite like Batman book that you've read?
Like Dark Knight Returns.
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of the popular choice. I really enjoyed The Long Halloween.
I was going to say Long Halloween.
I think it
as well.
Does like the best elements of Batman. He's got like the crazy kooky villains like Calendar Man and shit in there. But it's also got like the gang stuff because Gotham City is as much plagued by crazy supervillains as it is by organized crime.
Yeah.
So what does Calendar Man do? Because I'm just imagining he floods people's mailboxes with, like, fucking out-of-date calendars, and the postal system is just a mess.
He's pretty lame, but in The Long Halloween, he's kind of cool. He's like, sort of how... Have you seen Silence of the Lambs?
I think.
You know how they sort of visit Hannibal Lecter to talk about serial killers? Yeah. The Long Halloween has a lot of these murders happening. They start on Halloween. Mm. I think they go for like a year till the next Halloween. But like every holiday has like a murder.
Oh,
so it's a long Halloween because Halloween is like a year long. Yeah, and Calendar Man's kind of consulting on that because he's like, oh, it's kind of my shtick.
Yeah.
Someone has stolen it.
It's, I think, I'd say Long Halloween would be probably one of my favorites as well. Just
if you
just,
like, if you read it now, you see a lot of Nolan took a lot from that,
especially for the Dark Knight.
He took some stuff from like Dark Knight Returns and shit. What else?
Maybe Year One.
No, Killing Joke. I think just like elements.
Yeah,
but I think the storyline from Long Halloween is very similar to the Dark Knight Returns.
Yeah, the Harvey Dent stuff definitely.
But it's just it's a bit broader.
Mm. I really liked all the it's got like the kind of murder mystery
thing hanging out. It's a detective mystery.
Yeah, exactly.
Which a lot of comics overlook when it comes to Batman,
because
it's just like, oh, I'll do some crime fighting, and he just puts all the stuff into the computer.
Yeah,
and the magic Batman computer solves the crime.
Yeah, whereas this, he's got to use his wits. And there's bits where he's really like, Batman is genuinely really vulnerable. Like I really like the chapter where it's Father's Day, and there's this really nice moment where Bruce is like, just kind of at his wit's end and ends up literally there's like two pages where he's just having a cry on the stairs because he misses his dad, and Alfred comes over and like pats him on the shoulder and he looks up at Alfred.
It might have been the Long Halloween bit with Solomon Grundy on Thanksgiving where he leaves a plate of food for him.
That's
really nice.
That was sweet. But he like looks up at Alfred and he's like, I just miss him, Alfred, is that so wrong? And it's just kind of it's heartbreaking.
Have you read the one where Batgirl starts a citywide gang war?
No,
I can't remember what it's called, but that's really, really good as well.
Is Batgirl good or bad?
Oh, there's like three different Batgirls. This one was Spoiler, I think her name is. Or the name of who she was before she was Batgirl.
Mm-hmm.
And she reads, because Batman has like a contingency plan.
Mm-hmm.
If he wants to wipe out all the city's gangs in one like fell swoop.
Mm-hmm.
And she kind of steals that and tries to institute the plan.
Mm-hmm.
But she doesn't realize that one of the guys that's supposed to be there, I can't remember his name. But it's the alias that Batman uses when he goes undercover as a gangman.
Ah.
So because he isn't there, the plan just falls apart and all these gangs declare war.
That's cool. Yeah. There's a book written before the New 52. I think it was one of the last stories in Detective Comics before the New 52 reboot.
Mm.
The Black Mirror.
Yeah.
It's written by the dude who's doing Batman at the moment, Scott Snyder. Also did American Vampire, and he's doing a short series called The Wake at the moment, which is really good. And it's really cool. It's kind of it's got the murder mystery kind of elements, but it focuses a lot on Jim Gordon and Jim Jr. And fuck, that's a creepy character. Like what he does with that character is really weird. And there's some really cool kind of torture stuff in there.
And I think it's called Tower of Babel.
That's the JLA one, yeah?
Well, yeah, it's a JLA one, but it's focuses very much Batman-centric one, where essentially Batman has all these contingency plans for the members of the Justice League in case they go, like, off book or they just go crazy, because Justice League is essentially a group of, like, the seven most powerful men or superheroes in the world. So if one of them decides to fuck shit up, everyone's pretty much out of luck.
Yeah.
So he has all these plans to deal with them, and I think Ra's al Ghul steals the plans and pretty much takes out the whole Justice League, and everyone's like, what the fuck, Batman?
He's like, I'm sorry.
That's just the start. Then there's some more intrigue and stuff.
I haven't read that one.
Definitely read it.
Yeah.
They did a similar kind of thing in the New 52, but it seemed a lot cheesier. Like, instead of having these really intricate plans, he just had like a bunch of boxes labelled with the superhero on it, and literally like, oh, the Superman box has kryptonite on it.
I was imagining like a cardboard box with like kryptonite written in Sharpie on the side. Yeah.
And it's just like, if people steal that, it's like, well, shit.
Yeah.
You had that coming.
Mm.
It's like, that's cool. Box, kryptonite, next is like, bullet.
But yeah, so happy birthday to Batman, I guess.
What did you say your favourite Batman comic was, Catwoman?
I have some topics that my friends just texted me.
Oh, cool.
Oh,
my friend Ellie, hey Ellie, says secret handshakes.
I've never had friends who were like,
I don't have a secret handshake, but I've got a handshake. Me and Jared have a handshake.
What's the handshake?
It goes like this. Everyone watch.
Yeah, watching.
Okay, this is really hard to do on myself, but it goes, and then we hit the bus, and then we go, Mm-mm.
Okay.
All she did was slap her face a bunch of times.
You can't see this, but we're all like we're trying to restrain her. Yeah, I've never had friends who were like,
let's do a secret handshake. Yeah. It's like, you don't have enough friends to need a secret handshake.
Okay. Me and Ethan will come clean. We've got a secret handshake.
Do you know what secret means?
Fuck it. Live on air. We're about to do it. Ready?
Zip. Way.
Wait. Up the.
Yeah, there it is. Oh.
And out.
Don't wince.
Then, no, that's it.
And that's how you know we're friends.
Wait. Finish it off.
A mouth kiss?
Yeah.
I was thinking about, because Fifty Shades of Grey trailer came out.
That's a topic I was going to talk about.
I'm halfway reading through the first book.
I don't want to talk about 50 Shades of Grey. I want to talk about how literally everyone will respond to that when people are like, it's a shit movie. Like, oh, I know it's shit. It's just trashy, good humor, good fun. But like, we try and watch things like Transformers or The Expendables where it's just pointless action,
mm-hmm.
like popcorn films. Yeah. And people will be like, oh, they're just shit movies.
Mm.
And I feel like there's a double standard for that.
Yeah, definitely.
People that like want to watch 50 Shades of Grey will defend it, but people that want to watch Transformers that's the thing, will be like, I think, why are you watching that crap?
I was listening to another podcast. Because
there's
just
no real plot.
It's the like.
I haven't seen. Keeping in mind, I haven't seen any of the films.
Yeah, it's just schlock. It's just explosions and shit for 2 hours, which yeah. there's nothing wrong with.
No.
But like, it's no worse than, you know, softcore BDSM.
Yeah, so you go into 50 Shades of Grey, you know what to expect, and you go into Transformers, and you know what to expect. But for some reason, 50 Shades of Grey will be seen as like progressive in a way.
Yeah.
When it shouldn't be at all.
Yeah, I was listening to another podcast a while back.
Son of a bitch.
Yeah. there's a podcast. I'm not sure if you go on SoundCloud, there's
was
a podcast
it the second
called,
episode of this podcast?
No. There's a podcast called the Mantine Podcast, which is a bunch of British people. It's funny stuff. They've got like 2 episodes on SoundCloud at the moment. They're trying to get the rest their old episodes back up. But in the meantime, they got their first episode and like an unreleased B-side. Really good.
Yeah.
They were talking about 50 Shades of Grey at one point, and one of them mentioned being on a train where at least 3 women on the train were reading 50 Shades of Grey. This, like, lit erotica on the train. Nothing wrong with that. But then there was a dude reading, like, fucking their equivalent of, like, Zoo. Or
whatever.
And he was getting greasy, like, fucking greasy evils from this woman reading 50 Shades of Grey. It's kind of like, it's such a huge double standard. Why?
Yeah. I don't know. I guess because. Well, I think
we've got some friends. We were talking to some friends the other day about. Yeah. Or I was, rather. We were talking to some friends about this the other day. And one of them was reading it and was saying, oh, I'm reading it for the second time and it's so bad and blah, 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 but I keep reading it. I'm like, why? Why? Like, you've read the whole series, you've established you don't like it.
Yeah, I'm reading the first book at the moment and I read it on and off. Like, when I have a minute where I'm not doing anything, I might pick it up if I'm just, it isn't one of those books that I can't put down. Mm. And it isn't, I don't think it's, I don't know. I don't want to knock it because I'm like, what the fuck do I know? I've read the book.
Yeah, totally.
But I can understand why when people say it's not really well written. Mm. Like, it's not, like, great.
I mean, I'm sure everyone already knows this, but it started off as Twilight fan fiction.
Yeah, it's
really cool. Yeah.
You literally just changed characters.
Yeah, it's book porn, but I don't know. Okay, for instance, like, there's a Korean dance group on YouTube, right? And they're really, like, famous for their...
North Korea or South Korea?
Oh, I don't fucking know. It's all Korea. it's all just Korea, isn't it? And they're kind South of just tarty Korea. Dancers, but they have... And they're not great dancers. Mm. They're just kind of being slutty and wearing skimpy clothing. No, they're doing their thing.
Not
but, like,
North Korea, then. Unless it's Kim Jong-un doing his little dance.
But they've got, I think they're so, like, they've got so many subscribers just because it's chicks wearing pretty much nothing dancing around.
Yeah.
It's the same with the book. It's just book porn. So people go, yeah, I'll read that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, they're not like, I really want to capture the character in this novel.
I read a lot of just trashy fantasy stuff that's not like, ooh, this is high art or this is literature. It's just like, swords and dragons and, ooh, angst. Like,
yeah.
And I know exactly what it is and I don't defend it to people as anything other than like trashy, just like switch off and flick through it and be like, oh, that's cool, he's got a dragon and a golden sword and there's some elves. Like, I don't mind that. I like that but I don't pretend it's anything other than trashy fantasy.
Yeah,
it's not empowering me in any way.
Yeah, what bugs me is when people kind of either treat it as like, this is empowering and this is this and this is that. Well, no, so it's a fucking book that you dig. Great.
Yeah.
And it shits me equally when people are like, these people I was talking to the other day were talking shit about this book, but then getting really kind of passionately angry about what the movie was, what the movie trailer was. Like, they're like, oh, it's so shit. But the guy they've cast as Christian Grey, that is not Christian Grey. And they've got a girl with, like, a gap in her tooth playing Bella. What the fuck? And it's like, I mean... If you dig the book, dig the book. I don't give a fuck. Nobody gives a fuck. Enjoy what you enjoy.
Yeah.
Don't front like you hate this thing just to seem cool, but you secretly like it.
Yeah,
you know?
This is like when I said I don't get excited about anything. This is what I mean. Like, people who are like, they're like, I'm really passionate. When they're just kind of talking out their ass, I get really I don't know if you could say passionate, but when people are like, Justin Bieber's a faggot, I'm like, why? Because I don't understand.
He seems a bit douchey at the moment.
He's a cunt.
I don't know. I haven't met him.
I think we made him a cunt.
Yeah. I think people made him a cunt. I think everyone.
We made him a cunt, but he's
like,
still
he
a cunt.
Was 12, and everyone's going, "He's a faggot because he could sing and play guitar." Like,
when I went through puberty, I was a pretty awful teenager. I wasn't in the public eye. Yeah. Like, I wasn't like when I had a tantrum, it wasn't broadcast to like millions of people.
Yeah.
And the same, like, kind of on the other side, like, I never spat on people.
But he's basically
had people trying to help me and being like, "Yeah, fuck you, I'm crazy, ooh, ooh, ooh.
Yeah, I don't
I deserve it. I'm Justin Bieber."
because they
weigh each other out. I just decided I don't care.
Yeah, I'm the same, but I'm kind of like, I don't know.
But people that devote their life to like actively hating celebrities, it's just like, get over it.
Yeah. It's like, Jesus.
Have you not got anything else on at the moment, you know?
Like, some people,
that's like, people
know,
always take shit about Miley,
like,
Cyrus. Everyone's like, Miley Cyrus is a bad role model. It's like, well,
one guy that's convinced himself, he just like, he hates the Janoskians and that they've got everything. He doesn't.
I know. I mentioned this earlier when we were talking about the Janoskians. I usually try to be like, ah, fuck it, I'm just bitter. I accept I'm completely bitter with the Janoskians thing.
Yeah.
And it's petty and it's fucking stupid, but I can't help it.
You hate them.
I have hate with, like, I used to think, I don't hate anyone. I really fucking do. Like, there's this one person.
There's so much hate in my life.
Like, people who take the shit out of Miley Cyrus. I'm like, fuck y'all bitches. Like, she's just being Miley.
She's literally just being Miley.
But
the people that get mad at her for being, like, ooh, sexual and stuff and not being like, ooh, little Miley. She's not Hannah Montana.
She's not fucking 12.
That's a fictional character.
Yeah.
She's allowed to be like, I want to be sexy now because I'm in my 20s.
Yeah,
if
I
she
mean,
was still
like
on
sometimes
the Disney Channel, maybe.
Yeah, but she's not. You know?
Yeah, exactly.
She's
like
moving on with her fucking
life. But everyone's like, she's a bad role model and she's fucked up. And it's like,
and
Jesus
the thing is,
Christ,
like, people,
leave her alone.
People flip
like
their shit about like Miley Cyrus and Justin Bieber. Like, they've been caught smoking the ganj.
Yeah.
Kevin Smith is high on like nearly all of his podcasts. You can hear him like lighting up.
Yeah.
In the fucking in the studio, nobody bats an eyelid because it's fucking Fat Kev Smith. Nobody cares. But Justin Bieber, who's like, oh, he's a role model. Oh, he's gonna. And it's like,
He didn't decide to be a role model.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, you were the people that held him up as a role model.
Well, you have like half the world held him up as a role model. Half the world called him a faggot just because he was doing what he loved.
And like, same people that endorse these people that like follow them around.
Carly
says, go.
Okay, can you please talk about 12-year-olds who are in a relationship who think they are in love with each other, but why would? But Jesus, Bethlehem, had to, Carly, I love you, but they wouldn't know what it is. Okay, so she's practically saying 12-year-olds who are like, I'm in love with him, but do they really know what love is if they're 12? What do we think?
What is love?
Baby, don't hurt me.
Like,
hurt me.
Is love love? Whether
you can be in love
age.
Well.
I think you can really like someone at 12. I don't know how like legit it is. I mean, people will be like, oh, it's not love at 12. I mean, how much more legit is that feeling
when you're 20? No, because I sit there and I'm like, is this love? Because I don't really like what is love? Like,
baby, don't hurt me.
I think me and Jared are like, oh, I love you. But I think what that means to me is like, if he died, I'd be really sad. Like, and like I really care about him and I want him to
be
happy.
I love Christopher
Walken. And like I love my family, but I wouldn't
if he dies,
be like.
I'll be so sad.
But like, yeah.
Okay, serious. Love that motherfucker.
Ethan, I'll cherish you forever.
Yeah, but like, what?
Why? I'll be sad.
But what, like, is it not love if you Well, I mean, because really, are you in love?
People,
I mean,
like, I think 12-year-olds have a tendency to exaggerate it. Be like, went on a date with someone, held hands at the cinema, we're getting married in July.
But he doesn't know it yet.
Yeah.
I think some of them can take it seriously, but I think most do not. That's kind of what's led to it. Kind of
I
like,
mean, because I was like in love when I was like 15. I was like, oh my God, I love him. But then, like,
you realize you just love donuts. I don't love you. I just love donuts.
And you cut for some reason. You're always around donuts.
I think it was more just a thing of. I don't know because I'm still friends with that person and I still really care about.
Yeah.
If something happened to him, I'd be like, Jesus.
Yeah, like, I love my family and stuff, and there's people, like, friends and stuff that I love, and...
I don't want to get too Dr. Phil here.
No, but
sometimes,
like...
Sometimes there's loving people, and then there's just loving the attention you get from them.
Yeah. Also, like, I don't know about, like, you know, love and shit, but being in, like, that feeling of being in love, where you're, like, thinking about, like, people, the person, like, a lot, and you're like, this is really nice.
I know that feeling.
Yeah, that's a real feeling, and that's really nice.
I think with...
And
like,
for as long
instance,
as that lasts, it's like, yeah, cool.
My current...
And then it turns into awful, awful hate.
Like, I think...
bury it with drinks.
Like, for instance, when I was, like, in love when I was 15.
Phil?
When I was, like, in love when I was 15. But, like, it's different to now with Jared, because me and Jared are more, like...
More chilled when you're a bit older.
Yeah, and, like, we really live together, and it's, like, fucking hard work at times. Like, it's not all just jelly beans and stickers. It's, like, oh!
You work through each other's bullshit, and you still... If you can, like witness each other at your fucking worst,
he has still
be able to be, like, I care about this motherfucker
like,
enough.
He has...
How much of it is jelly beans and stickers?
I'm tossing up whether or not this relationship thing is worth it.
Oh, when we were at the that sugar sweet place earlier, and they sell, like... individual jelly beans, not individual jelly beans, but like buckets of individual jelly belly. What's the point of that?
Well, what if you don't like specific flavors?
Then you don't like jelly belly. The point of jelly belly is like, you get a handful, you're like, oh, this was nice.
I want blue.
The danger is what I'm talking about. Thrill.
I'm worried. I'm worried we're getting too.
When I eat jelly belly, I feel alive.
I feel like we're getting too Dr. Phil now.
That's too Dr. Phil.
If you want to get like mad Dr. Phil, I had a spa party with Lachlan and Mr. Black, and you know, just a bunch of people and shit. We were going over. Lachlan brought over like two packets of like the every flavored beans.
Yeah.
And we kept taking one out of the packet without looking. I'm just fixing my eyes. I feel weird about doing this. We kept taking like one bean out of the packet, not looking at it. Everyone just ate it. And there were two girls there that are particularly squeamish.
Yeah.
So it's like, they'd be like, I don't want to eat it. And then they'd eat it and it's like, oh, it's dead.
Like an ewer.
Yeah, they actually had those flavors and we couldn't stop laughing. And that's my story.
That's my
contribution to love.
I think you had something about it not being stickers and gum drops or whatever.
Jelly beans.
But I cut you off to tell my jelly bean anecdote.
Okay. Like, for instance, in my current relationship, because, like, I can be a real fucking cunt sometimes.
Yeah.
And I'm like, man, I would not be with me right now. But then Jared's still like, no, you're all right. Like, he'll be like, hey, don't be a fucking bitch. And I'll be like, well, okay. I'll be like, give me food and then I'll think about it. Just for a relationship.
Give me some jelly beans.
Big man.
Yeah.
Bring me some stickers and some fucking jelly beans. The sticker jelly bean ratio is out of fucking whack. Yeah.
Okay, James, my friend James Noonan, hey Noonan, says, embarrassing body facts from everyone. Okay.
Well, like, embarrassing facts about our bodies?
I'm worried, okay, like, alright, I've got
how
Nini.
Come, like, I never run out of ass hair? Every time I wipe, I feel like I'm pulling them out. Still there. Still ass hair.
No, you keep eating hair. That's why there's always ass hair when you wipe.
And that's because I'm not a particularly hirsute person. There's a lot of hair.
Yeah, like,
I consider shaving them, and I read this amazing like blog post some guy did about, just went into such detail about, essentially he shaved his ass cheeks, and it was like two cheese graters just rubbing against
him. Yes.
So I was like, okay, well, I'm not going to do... Plus, I don't...
Body fat guy.
By that, you mean things I should be embarrassed about.
He's an embarrassing body fat. Guy has an embarrassing body. Not embarrassing.
You've got a good... What's annoying is about your body is that it's so great despite...
It's a freak of nature.
Awful.
Yes.
Yeah, what's with that?
I eat a lot of pizza and I sit down lots. Keeps me nice and thin.
I do sit downs.
Well, I had fucking hand aids.
Yeah, yeah. You've contributed enough on the embarrassing body thing. Yeah. You don't have to answer this one, I think.
Yeah. You've got more, but the female body is just so, like...
Disgusting.
There's so much work to be done for it to be socially acceptable. No, like, with girls, you got, like, stretch marks and cellulite and, like... Everything's supposed to be fucking toned and tight. I read a thing online with a
dude called stretch marks cake scars.
What?
I've got cake scars.
I'm stealing that.
It's cake scar city.
Cake scar city is what we should have called the podcast.
Yeah, that's true. They are cake scars.
Yeah.
I got a cyst above my ass.
Yeah, you do too.
I do. There's like...
I don't know.
What?
I don't want to know.
You love it.
Last question.
There's like a sweat pore above your ass that apparently, like, it's not uncommon, but it's not common. Like, you know, it's one of those middle things that every once in a while someone gets like that area infected, and apparently gets like really like fucking infected and pussy and shit.
Mm-hmm.
With me, it got infected. There was no pus or anything. The body kind of dealt with it itself, and doctors don't know how. Mm. They're just like, we're not even going to touch this. Just. You have this, like, now calcified cyst in your ass that hasn't done anything.
Jesus Christ.
We're not going to cut it out because it probably will get infected. Just have it.
Are you on, like, banner ads on websites now? Like, picture a guy with your butt out saying, doctors hate him.
Yeah.
See this one housewife's simple trick for dealing with an ass cyst.
I've got, like, five things that doctors just don't know why. Doctors don't know why that is.
I think maybe, like, you just forgot that you were some kind of, like, human designed by aliens to blend in, and they just fucked up on a few things, like...
That's why I don't know my dad!
They were just doing, like, pizza. They were doing, like, what he eats, and they're just like, okay, pizza, steak, and then they got distracted. That's all you eat.
Pizza, steak. You got some candy over there? Oh shit, candy's... Yeah, fuck it.
I think you were just manufactured to resemble humans. You're 95% human. And 5% Loch Ness monster.
That would not surprise most people. That's why I love fish so much.
My body's perfect.
It is.
My body is a wonderland.
Oh my god!
Body. If you had to, like, just something reach, some nitpick your body.
I've got weird body hair. Like, it's not all, like, sexy and, like, it's kind of sporadic. It's, like, sporadically dotted around. The hairs around my nipples are, like, weirdly long. It's gross. It's a scene, man.
Sorry,
I think the funny thing is, like, when I was, like, year 10, I didn't really eat that much. And I was, like, a lot, like, me and Jared were playing, that one with Alan DeGeneres game.
Oh, the heads.
Ding, heads up. And he's like, okay, you were this 2 years ago. And I was like, skinny. And he was like, no, 16. I was like, oh, okay.
Happy. So dark.
Oh, satisfied.
But the thing is, like, over just, like, I don't know, like, I hit 16 and just went poof. Like, oh, like, gained all the weight.
Is it just because your metabolism slows down and you're not used to it?
I think it's because I started eating, but like.
But, I mean, also, like. I'll do it. Yeah. No, but also, I mean, you met Jared and you're like.
I got really fucking comfy. But, like, the thing is, I'm that, like, the heaviest.
Fuck, I can stop trying.
Yeah.
Like, the heaviest I've ever been, but, like, the happiest most. I've ever been. But the most comfortable I've ever been. And, like, the most, like, confident in just being, like, I'm not a fucking skinny bitch. What up?
You grew into yourself? That's what they say in counselling sessions. You really grown into yourself.
What the fuck does that mean?
Because they're like,
you got fat, bitch. He's like,
yeah. I grew into myself and three other people.
James also has another topic. He says, most rebellious story from high school. Has anyone got one? I've got...
I didn't go to high school for 2 years. That's pretty rebellious.
Yeah.
YOLO. I've got a few.
Also, one time I walked out of a media class and got a McChicken instead.
did you come back? Because
you didn't do any of the work.
I hadn't done any. She's like, okay, so how much of your work have you done? I'm like, oh, no. She's like, oh, I don't think you should be in the class. I'm like, oh, okay, I'll just go then. Walked off, got a McChicken. It was good. Went home.
It was good. She was like, I think you should just go then. And you're like, yeah, okay. Kind of walked out. That was it. I don't know, I'll think. You got one.
I wouldn't say I was rebellious in the sense that I didn't show up.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wagged a lot of school and got fish and chips and stuff.
Yeah, I wagged a lot of school. I think the worst thing I did was I wagged a lot of psych and maths classes and some Japanese.
I missed, and I slept.
Any maths classes I showed up to, I slept through.
Yeah, I was the same. I did fuck all. My teachers got to the point where they were just like, do you want to be here? And I was like, no.
Yeah.
And they're like, okay, just... But I wasn't disruptive. I wasn't like that kid.
No, exactly. I put my headphones in and shut the fuck up.
I'd read. Yeah. Or I just wouldn't fucking go. And my teachers just said, do you want to pass? I said, yeah, I guess.
That'd be good, sir.
Yeah, and so they just, like, gave me the bare minimum, said, do this. I did it all in, like, a whole VC year's worth of work in a week. Shut.
Oh, that Jurassic Park's coming out. Not Jurassic Park, Jungle Book. We were talking about this yesterday. Yeah. They're doing it sort of like live action with cartoon characters.
The actual bears.
And
like Mary Poppins?
They announced, I think, Giancarlo Esposito, Gus from Breaking Bad, is going to be in it.
Oh, cool.
Jesus.
Just back on the... Back on the rebellious thing. Guy, you got any rebellious stories?
I don't really do anything. I've never wagged.
You didn't show up. When you say you didn't do anything, you mean that. Like,
literally,
you missed a lot of days of school and stuff.
The first year 12, if I was sick, I'd like still try and turn up to school. If I was feeling shit, I'd still try and turn up to school. Then I'd be away for like a week, just like fucking ill. Mm. Yeah, the next year of year 12, I did. If I felt slightly sick, I'd just sleep. Then when I woke up, if it was like kind of before like 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock, you know, something reasonable, I'd turn up to school, kind of thing.
Yeah.
But that second year of year 12, I had like high marks on all my sacks.
Mm.
No teacher was annoyed with me. Every teacher was fine. Mm. I had, like, no book work, and every teacher just marked me on my sex and things like that. I'd turn up to every class. I was never disrespectful or anything.
Mm.
And it just worked through. Like, I even talked with the principal. The principal's like, your attendance is, like, appalling. I'm like, yeah, but I've got all my work done. Everything's done. Yeah. Like, that's exactly what you want.
She's I never had...
Just don't tell anyone
that. I never had the urge to be rebellious at school. Because our parent, like, our parents were both teachers, and hearing them kind of talk about, like, kids just being cunts just because because the teacher can't, like, smack you in the fucking head anymore for being a little cunt. Like, I just thought, why do I want to make this person's day any fucking harder than it already is? They've already got, you know, fucking... Damo in the back with his fucking rat tail shouting
and
shit.
His fucking box cutter.
Yeah, and his box cutter fucking around. Like,
I love you, miss.
They don't need me doing anything. I think I was never rebellious. I was a little bit like, I don't know, sassy. Like if a teacher was like, why didn't you do your work? I'd be like, I just didn't. Sorry. I'm sorry, but I didn't do it.
Yeah.
It's more truthful than anything.
I couldn't be bothered bullshitting where they'd be like, what's your excuse? I'd be like, no excuse. I'm just fucking lazy. Sorry.
I only had that from one math teacher. Was like, why haven't you done your work? I was like, I just haven't done it. I didn't get around to doing it. Didn't want to do it. Sorry. And he's like, well, you're not sorry. I'm like, sorry. He's like, stop saying sorry. You're not sorry. I'm
like, you're like, soz, not soz.
Soz. Sorry. Hashtag soz, not soz.
I think only, like, in year 10, because it was, like, impossible to wag, I wagged one time. Mm.
It was impossible to wag.
Because Carol, I know you're going to listen to this, she was like, wag, wag, wag. And I was like, And, like, I'm a down-ass bitch. So I was like, yeah, okay.
I'm a boss-ass bitch.
Don't you want to play a bitch like this?
Drop a little picket of just like this.
What?
In year 12, when I had those two subjects that I knew I wasn't going to pass, media and film,
yeah,
I wagged so much. But, like, I never got good at it. So we walk out and like the teacher would be like, you don't have any afternoon classes, do you? But no, I don't. I'm not having any afternoon classes because I had afternoon, but then my schedule changed. And whereas people I was wagging, we were just like, nah, miss.
Fuck off, miss.
Love it. Fuck off, miss.
You love it, miss. Grab the dick and stuff. I think that actually, you know what? The most rebellious I ever got was not to a teacher. It was the fucking librarians.
Oh.
I despised librarians.
They're not even real librarians. You have to go to school to get a library. You have to get a... Like
yeah. They're like fucking libraries. Substitute teachers that just happen to work in the school library. But anyway, so whenever a librarian would come over, I'd be sitting just like reading fucking quietly, or we'd be talking quietly amongst ourselves, and they'd come over and just like abuse the little bit of power they had at this fucking school.
Yeah.
I would see red and I would just be a cunt to them.
Yeah.
It's like you got these kids in the back with the rat tails and stuff drawing dicks in the books, but yeah. It's like, oh, let's talk to the kids that are sitting quietly having fun with their friends.
Yeah. Yeah. We're laughing about something in a magazine or something, like a Mad magazine or something, and they come over and be like, you know,
Are you doing work?
No. Have you got work to be going on with?
Yeah. And I'd be like, do you?
Yeah, clearly
not. Apparently
not. Fuck off.
So
yeah.
I was fucking rude to those people, but I kind of don't.
Yeah. Well, the one thing that I like remember doing when I was like, shit, was I ditched a class. It was really embarrassing, actually. I ditched a class I'd been to all my classes, and then at lunchtime, me, Kane, Carol, and Darcy were like, fuck this, we're going to wag. Mm. And so went to our locker, grabbed our bags, and we ran out. And we walked past Nijiu Primary School, and the office ladies from Nijiu Primary School called EKC and was like, oh, they're wagging. Mm. And Mr. Black. He drove past in his car, and we saw us at the bus stop, and was like, get back to school now. And then I had to go back to my science class, and I'd had that teacher earlier in the day, and she's like, did you try and fucking wag? And I was like, yes. And all the kids laughed at me, like, oh, fail, epic fail. And I was like, fuck. And then mum and dad called me and were like growling and shit. Mum was like, that was so fucking stupid.
All right, mum. All right, sweetie, put mum on the phone. Sweetie being your dog.
Yeah.
I have walked out of a class, actually.
Yeah?
Yeah, I just really, in year 12, because I just taught like I would to anyone, to everyone in every class. Our media teacher put Rebecca Black on. And if there's something, I'm like, Sims, you turn that off now. And he didn't. I'm like, right, I'm leaving. I'll be back in 5. You call me when this is done. I just walked out. Took my stuff, went to my locker, took a drink, came back about 5-10 minutes later and sat down. And he's like, he was just cool with it.
Hardest classes to wags were the ones that had the break in the middle.
Yeah.
So go to the first class and then just leave after the second. Like, where's Ethan today? Oh, he's not here, miss. I could have sworn. No, I must be here. He was right. No, I guess not. His work's
no,
still there.
No, smacked his glasses off his head and called him a nerd. I know he's here. Teachers were weird.
Yeah.
Sexy, but weird.
Evil Dead is being developed into a TV series, which is pretty cool. Sam Raimi's producing it with his brother and Bruce Campbell. So that'll be cool. And he's also producing Left 4 Dead, Last of Us movie.
He's producing it, but he's not like directing it or anything.
No, but I think he's... I mean, he produced the... Fuck, what
remake?
The remake of The Grudge? No, The Ring? The Grudge? No.
Oh, yeah.
Which one was the one that was still set in Japan? The Grudge.
Sarah Michelle Gellar, I think.
Yeah, yeah, he produced that, and that was fairly well received compared to most...
Really? I thought The Ring was well received, and The Grudge was kind of like, we already have this.
Isn't it the same?
No, The Ring's the one with the tape. The Grudge is the one where with the house and the little girl's like,
okay.
They're two different films. Both
of them have the long black hair?
Both of them have creepy little girls.
Creepy little girls with long black hair. The Grudge, The Ring, and Dark Water are like three I can name off the top of my head that have that same kind of trope.
Girl, yeah.
Well, the Japanese are just
so what, what's the one where the phone rings and it's like, you're gonna die in 7 days?
That's
Scream.
That's The Ring.
And really?
Well, Scream is the, what's your favourite scary movie?
What about I Know What You Did Last Summer? What do they say in that?
I Know What You Did Last Summer.
Okay.
Yeah. I hope Bruce Campbell doesn't die before they like get to do something else. Yeah. I want to see him in something else.
They also announced they're going to do Kill Bill, The Whole Bloody Affair, which is a supercut of Kill Bill 1 and 2 with an extended Oren Ishii sequence, the anime sequence.
Mm-hmm.
Huh. That's going to come out in select cinemas. But they've been talking about that for literally, I think the movies came out a decade ago now.
Mm-hmm.
And they've been talking about doing it since like a year after release.
Mm.
So they're like... originally refilmed intended. Or like no. Everything put together kind of shit.
Like Kill Bill Volume 1 and 2 is originally intended to be one film. Yeah. It was just too long, so we cut it down. And you can kind of tell because it's like the narrative, the pacing's a bit weird.
Yeah, yeah. Because
there's like more action in the first part and more like dialogue, revenge stuff in the second.
Oh, yeah.
This will just put them all together like that with that sound effect.
Oh.
And there's a scene.
Midway through the film, you hear and it continues with the second.
Everyone
bit.
Looks at each other.
There's a scene where she fights the crazy 88. They had to do in black and white because they couldn't. Because if they did it in color, it was too violent. They couldn't get a MA rating, I think.
Seems weird. Yeah.
So it'll come out in color.
That's
really
cool.
Oh shit!
I'm super excited for that.
Yeah. Speaking of movies, Michael Gervaz sent in a thing, a topic question for us to talk about. What film do you regret paying to see in the cinema? / What film do you regret not seeing at the cinema?
I couldn't think. I kind of regret not seeing Godzilla recently in IMAX.
Okay, yeah.
Because that was a really good looking film.
That would have been pretty stunning.
I haven't seen any films I like literally regret seeing. There's a movie I spoilers. I don't want to, I downloaded for my mum's friend.
Yeah.
I can't remember. What it was. Maybe it was called something borrowed. And I had it downloaded. I'm like, I'll check this out. Mm-hmm. I watched 5 minutes and it was god awful.
Mm.
It was like, it shouldn't have been a movie.
Yeah, Something Borrowed. It's like a rom-com, isn't it?
Yeah. I had the guy from The Office and I'm like, oh, I like The Office. I'm like, no.
Mm.
Bad movie. Don't watch it. What is you doing?
Kat just tips some Pepsi on Ethan's mother can.
What is you doing?
What is you doing? Lady, what is you doing?
She's still doing it.
She's still doing it. Lady.
Oh!
Don't do that, you tit.
I was just looking at next it, and week, I thought
no
it might.
No guess. You don't get that.
Next week, no podcast.
Solo.
In terms of films that I regret paying to see, I think there's two. So when Hot Fuzz came out, I went and saw it in cinemas. I was 14. I shouldn't have been let in, but the first time I went and saw it, I got let in. Like me, a friend Jake, a friend Zach at the time, and one other person, I think.
Might have
just been us three. Yeah, year 8. And they didn't ask for ID, so we got in, and I fucking loved it. And I tried to see it another 3 or 4 times, and they wouldn't let me in because I wasn't 15.
This is a big moment for God. Like, MSN back in these days, he literally had about a year countdown, like days till Hot Fuzz is out.
Did I?
You did, on Jesus. MSN. It was there. It was like...
I did too, because I saw the trailer, and I fucking like flipped. I was so excited.
I think it literally may have gone up to a year.
Anyway.
This guy.
I'm like, that is so gay.
Fuck you.
Because we're in the mindset of 2006 MSN, so we can say gay as an insult.
Yeah,
still.
True.
Yeah.
spastic. So, yeah, I was so excited for that movie. So I got to see it the week it came out. It was great. And I tried to see it a bunch of other times. Didn't get to go in. The one time... Ooh, this is fairly rebellious. I tried to do the thing where you buy a ticket for another movie and sneak in to the other movie. I bought a ticket. I didn't make up my mind that I was going to do that until I got into the movie. So I went and bought a ticket for Wild Hogs.
Oh, I saw
and
that.
I yeah, fucking, I was sitting there and I was like, this is so fucking stupid compared to what I could be watching again. So I left the cinema and was like, I was just going to walk out and go home. But then I saw the door open for the Hot Fuzz cinema and I was like, I snuck in and I was in the aisle, the middle aisle, just kind of stood there frozen like, this is... I could go to prison for this shit. I couldn't have. I was just like... But I just shit myself. I was like, I'm doing something wrong. I don't know if I can go through with this. And then the usher guy kind of came in, looked at me. I was like, I was just... where am I? Just kind of waddled out.
That doesn't look like John Travolta.
Where are the Harley bikes? Yeah, so I left. And I tried getting my money back. And they're like, no, you tried sneaking into another film. I'm like, but the film you sent me to was shit.
Did actually say that?
Well, not in those exact words. But they wouldn't give me my money back. And when I got home and was like, yeah, they wouldn't give me my money back. My dad's like, oh, I'll ring him and see if I can, straighten it out. And then he, gets up and he's like, Connor, I'm like, yeah. He's like, you tried sneaking into another movie? I'm like, yeah. And he's like, yeah, well, they don't want to give you money back because of that. I'm like, oh, fuck. All right, fuck. So, yeah, I don't know. Wild Hogs I regret paying money for. And Amazing Spider-Man 2.
You regret paying money for
I regret
for.
Paying money for
it's
that.
It's so bad that you regret.
I would have rather...
I really liked it.
$15 I
I really liked it, but I liked it because I found it kind of female-friendly. It was, soft action.
Yeah. It's kind of thing, you could take out the Spider-Man parts and there'd just be a rom-com with Peter Andrew Garfield and
Emma Stone. That's exactly why I liked it. But then there was kind of just there's a giant lizard running the city, and so I was kind of
that was in the first one.
First one.
Yeah. But I really liked the second one as well. Oh my god, it killed me when Gwen Stacy...
Yeah. I
and she died. I was like... Mm.
It was one of those things that I came out of and I saw it, but if I had to really think of something that I regret paying money for, I wasn't very happy when I came out of that movie.
Some of the paranormal activities.
Paranormal Activity 3 then, yeah.
We see them out of habit now.
Yeah, I guess. No, Paranormal Activity, 4, because that was just shit.
Yeah.
So that,
I haven't seen any of the Paranormal
But I think, I say Amazing Spider-Man 2... You go into Paranormal Activity knowing it's going to be shit. I went into Amazing Spider-Man 2 kind of really excited and hoping I was going to enjoy it, and I didn't.
I really enjoyed it.
Yeah. And I know that's my problem.
Yeah, but, I mean, it's your problem.
Yeah.
Hot Tub Time Machine was one thing that I saw with, this boy when I was in, year 9 or something.
Yeah, didn't dig it.
Year 9, really?
It was just fucking stupid, and it was such a boy... of course, he chose the movie, and it was just...
Yeah.
I like that movie.
And, like, the boy was stupid, and the movie was stupid, and it was just like,
so it was more of a bad movie-going experience for you than anything.
Yeah, and the movie shit as well.
Oh, okay.
I don't know. Have you? I can't remember. I remember it thinking, "Why the fuck am I here?"
Yeah.
But I was too polite to go. Fuck this! I don't need this shit. Do you know who I am? Flip the table and get out. And then 22 Jump Street. But I really liked the movie. But
I really like 22 Jump Street.
What was yeah, like? No, it was. I regret going that night because the cinema was absolutely packed, and there was stupid. Like, oh my god, bro, sitting behind us. Yeah.
Why don't you suck his dick?
Like, two chicks and two guys.
Yeah.
And the fucking stupid females really fucking annoy me.
Why is it?
Like, every time Channing Tatum would pop up on the screen, which was most of the fucking movie, believe it or not, they'd be like, oh my god, he's so hot. Oh my god, he's so fucking hot. And I was like, shut up, shut up. And the boys were like, or they were laughing really fucking loudly.
Who does that in public?
Who does that in comedies?
Like, no, like, but like at things that weren't actual jokes. Like when there was an actual joke, they didn't get it. But when it would just be like Jonah Hill doing something stupid, they'd be like, oh, oh, and I was like, shut up. And the boys just had commentary the whole fucking time.
I think about people that do comments in films, it's like, if your comments were funny enough to, like, if your comments were fucking funny, funnier than the stuff in the movie, you'd be a director.
You'd have a fucking writer. Movie, yeah.
Yeah.
But saying, like, hey, he's gonna, he's gonna look at his dick, hey, bro.
Yeah.
That's not funny.
That's pretty much what it was. So the same movie was not, like, I left the cinema being, like, like, really angry. And because I said to Jared at the start of the meeting, I said, these guys are gonna be
trouble.
Cunts the whole time. So can we leave? And he went, no, because they were talking through the previews. Mm. And I fucking love the previews.
Same.
I go to the cinemas to watch the fucking previews. That's my favorite part. And I like have my popcorn, have my fucking sody pop that I paid $17 for. I want to enjoy this shit.
You gotta go to the Safeways before, get a whole bottle of
Jared. Jared likes to go and get the cinema stuff. He's like, if I'm here,
has he got a shopper docket for it?
He probably does. He actually does. He's got like a 2 for $22 ticket thing.
We had the same experience when we went and saw Paranormal Activity 3.
Well, I was going to say, we had almost the same experience, but our friend Emma stood up and told him to shut the fuck up.
Yeah, well, not even shut the fuck up. Emma is a fucking bad bitch.
Is she the one with the glasses and like the
Don't you want a bad bitch like this? Fucking,
what did she do?
These people are like talking during the previews, and
we were like, whatever.
Yeah, like, whatever. And then they start talking, the opening credits start, they're still talking and laughing. Emma just turns around and goes, shut up! And they just shut the fuck. The entire cinema shuts the fuck up.
You know there were people like opening chip packets, but oh god.
How old are the people who are talking?
Just like probably like 16, 17, 18.
See, when we went to
Paranormal Activity, we couldn't have done that because they were in there. Like the people behind us were like. The kind of cunts with the rat tails and tribal tattoos.
Who would be like,
you want a fucking go cunt? And it's like, no, I want to watch the fucking movie for you, dumb cunt.
Yeah, wait, that's exactly how I feel.
Paranormal Activity outside with my fist paranormals up your ass. It doesn't make sense, but I'm still scared.
All right, guy, go.
Oh, fuck, I got a mixture of both. Like, there's not really a film that like I've regretted seeing. There's not really a film that like I was like, oh, fuck. Like, you know, I missed that. Pissed off.
Yeah.
Mm. It was like films that I'm kind of like, oh, didn't see that. Oh, well. But like, I'm not fast. One of my exes tried to take me on a date and I just was not interested in her. I was up the entire night beforehand. She took me to see Sherlock Holmes, so I paid for that.
Yeah.
I was really enjoying it, just fucking passed out. Like, maybe 30 minutes in. And I remember, like, trying to stay awake because, like, this is really interesting. And I just kept passing out, like, 5 times. I, like, woke up at the edge. Oh, he fell asleep. I'm like, why the fuck didn't you wake me?
Okay, speaking of, like, just a little anecdote about, Dad, what's our dad like? He's a bit of a bad bitch when it comes to telling people to shut the fuck up in cinemas and theatres in particular. Our dad went and saw Cat in, wasn't Hairspray, it was the year before.
Chicago.
I think it was The Wiz. Cat was playing the Scarecrow in The Wiz.
Oh, yeah.
Dad was sat up in the thing, you know, waiting for the play to start. And there were these three... Yeah, there were these three boys in, you know, 16, 17.
Were you with him?
No. They were like 16, 17-ish. Yeah. And,
just stupid. Just oh, my being, God. Yeah, Loggy stupid. Cunts. Yeah.
Just being loudmouthed little kids. Yeah. And wouldn't shut up. And they were talking really loudly and being kind of obnoxious, making everyone uncomfortable. Dad thought, they'll stop when the lights go down. Lights go down. They're still talking. They'll stop when the curtains go up. Curtains go up. The first song starts. And which they're still talking. Which Cat sings.
Yeah.
Dad leans over and just goes, like, they're like, Dad leans over and just goes, shut the fuck up. And they're like, they kind of jump back and go, who's going to make it? Who's going to make me? Like, the lead. Yeah, yeah. Who's going to make me? And my dad just goes, me, motherfucker.
And he threatened to throw him off the balcony if he didn't shut the fuck up. Yeah, he's like, that's my fucking daughter up
there. Yeah, the kid's like, well, what are you going to do? And he's like, I'm going to throw you over the fucking balcony. And his kids just shut the fuck up.
Yeah. And then Dad got up and left in the second act and went and sat at the front and was like, ah.
Yeah. And then, like, later on, he was sitting outside the theater waiting for you with some flowers and shit.
Yeah.
And he saw them, like, scurrying out looking around for him and shit.
Got you boys some flowers. I really enjoyed our first date.
That's one thing that I like about Daddy. He's such a nice...
Well, the thing
guy.
Is, he's really, whenever he talks to people, like companies on the phone, and you know, you hear people talk to telemarketers and stuff, he's really calm and polite. Where some people, they'll talk to people on the phone who are just doing their jobs, and they'll treat them like shit.
Yeah.
Dad is like reverse Batman in that way. He's really polite to adults and stuff because he's like, they're just doing their job. But if a kid's like bratty to him, he'll just like fuck with them.
Yeah. Just like he treats kids the same way he treats adults. So if like an adult started being like, throwing a hissy fit, anyone will be like, shut the fuck up.
Yeah.
Throw you off a balcony.
Yeah.
That house, I'm going to knock on their door and say, hey, can I borrow your balcony? I'm going
to
go
throw this
off. I'm going to throw you off a fucking balcony.
Yeah.
Okay, here's actually another discussion.
Okay.
My friend, I was speaking to my friend Paul, and he is a homosexual. I was going to say he's a homo.
He's a fucking homo.
Hashtag no homo, but yes homo. And he is the most untrendy person I've ever met, right? Like he's outfits, that's some basic shit. Bitch, you basic. And like he admitted to me when we're at this coffee, when we're having this coffee, that he hasn't bought new clothes in 4 years. But then a girl walks past and he's like, bitch, what is she wearing? If you're gay, does that give you permission to be sassy about what other people are wearing?
I think if you're gay, you're expected to be sassy.
Yeah,
you don't
but
to be.
Maybe,
like,
I mean, maybe he feels pressured.
Person.
Maybe he feels pressured.
And
to
I
be
said
sassy.
To him, and I looked at him, and I said, "Don't you fucking dare,
you homo!"
I said,
"Where do you get off other men's penises?" Obviously,
doesn't give you the right to sass or dress sense.
But yeah, like, if you're gay, does that then give you the permission?
No.
To be like, uh-uh, yes, like, sister, permission to...
Is it permission? Like, I mean, is that a prerequisite? I know it's not a prerequisite for being gay, but it's like, there seems to be a lot, like, gay people are a lot sassier than straight people, it seems.
I mean, I've got some gay friends who aren't sassy. Mm.
Or flamboyant, no.
I mean, Paul's not sassy at all.
Or is it just
he's
like
a real like bloke's bloke. Right. Like he's like you would never guess that he loves a dick, but he
is
does
it
in
just
fact
like a confirmation bias thing where you only notice someone being sassy when they're gay. It's like, oh,
I mean, there are some people where you just know that they're
sassy, he's gay. But then when like I've been described as sassy before, but I'm not like
Ethan just minds sucking dicks. Yeah, you're witty. You're not like...
You're not sassy.
Or maybe you just call it witty and not sassy because I'm straight.
Yeah, maybe.
Oh, you should check that privilege.
Yeah. Well, there were kids in high school that were very kind of flamboyant and sassy and stuff that weren't out at the time. And I always kind of maintain that the people will be like, oh, that kid's totally gay. I'm like, oh, fuck it. Maybe he probably isn't. Maybe he is. Who gives a shit? Mm. But then since then they've come out and I'm kind of like, oh, fuck, I stand corrected. You know? So I'm kind of like, what is it?
But then, like, I've met people I've thought, oh, he is gay, and then turns out they're just really polite.
Turns out they're really nice. They're really good people.
Yeah, you remember Jared?
You must love dick.
You remember Jared?
Cowan? Yeah.
I used to call, like, when we actually used home phones, I used to, like, call out and be like, oh, like, is Jared there? And, like, he'd be, like, whoever and whoever answer the phone. His grandmother was convinced I was gay.
Mm.
I'm just polite.
Yeah, like
I'm just like, Jared, hey, is Jared there? Yeah.
Is Jared there? I'd really like to suck his dick.
Did I say suck? I meant come up to play.
With my dick.
just like fucking disclaimer, if you gay or straight, we don't give a fuck. Good on you.
Connor does.
No.
Do what you do, girl. I just had a fucking violent flashback to one time I was sat playing Prince of Persia, Sands of Time on the PlayStation 2. Really enjoying myself. And my mum was in the kitchen talking to one of her friends, and they were talking about this friend's like nephew or something.
Yeah, what friend?
And she was like, Laura.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So we're talking about
Laura.
So yeah, she's going to listen. So she's talking
more
to this
like
Laura woman,
Laura.
And this Laura woman's talking about her nephew or something.
Yeah.
And says, you know, oh, he's a really good kid. You know, he helps out with his sisters are a little bit you know, hard and stuff. Hard? Her sister's a little bit hard to teach and stuff, and he helps out so much, and he's really great. He's really polite. He's a lot like Connor. And I hear Mum under her breath go, "Is he gay?" And I'm just there playing Prince of Persia. I'm like, what the fuck?
Am I gay?
Yeah.
I remember
you have to tell me.
I remember, like...
You have to tell me.
You were 12, yeah?
No, I was like 15 or 16. I was like, what the fuck?
I remember, like...
I would have been 15.
When I was like 16, I had a date with a boy. Ooh. My dad, and I was wearing, like, I wasn't dressed like a hoe bag.
But you weren't wearing pants.
Like, no, I was wearing pants, and dad goes, "Do you like this boy?" And I'm like, "Yeah." And he goes, "Well, then don't dress like a dyke." And then made me go and put a dress on. Okay, shut up. Anyway, one of my biggest poo fears is when you're at a party or something, and there's always a line with the girl for the girls to go to the toilet.
Yeah.
Is taking a really, really big poop,
mm-hmm.
and either not having any air freshener to spray it down,
yep.
or the poop not flushing.
Oh my
and
God.
Then there's a line of girls out the front. And I was saying to my friend, following off coffee, I said, and he said, "What would you do?" And I said, "This is what I'd fucking do."
Paula, you motherfucker.
I'd be like, I'd take the giant poop.
Mm.
It wouldn't be able to flush. Oh. There's a line of girls who are
you
waiting
walk
for
out
the door.
Holding it. Check it.
Yeah.
You go around the party and you high five literally everyone.
And
with the other hand.
And I'll just... I just have to own it.
You'd have to, so go, you'd like open the door and be like...
I'd be like, there are
sisters!
Two...
Sisters!
We're doing it for ourselves!
No. I just walk out...
You walk out,
stare
like,
the girl directly in the eye who is gonna about to witness my two chocolate cakes. And just say,
just double down.
And this is what I say.
Double up. Boy.
It is what it is. And then grab my friend Paul. Paul, we gotta go. We gotta go. No. He's like, why? I'm like, I just took a massive shit. I clogged up the toilet. Everyone knows it was me. I'm gonna
Paul
be.
Just says,
everyone's gonna be
Katlin?
Pointing at me, going, "That's the chocolate cake girl. We need to go now."
Chocolate
and then
cake.
Never
what have you
ever
just
seen them again.
Says, it is what it is. No, you don't get to use that line on me. You just walk out and you're like, guess what? I did a shit. People shit. Get over it.
Wow.
I know, but with girls, you're not allowed to do poops.
No.
Like, I've got girlfriends and they're like, I will not poop at a guy's house. I am so comfortable with me and Jared's relationship. I'm like,
I'll
have
poop
you...
in his mouth.
Like, literally, he's been kind. I'm like, I will literally poop on you.
You're like, I will drop trowel. Plant.
I'm like, I would drop the bucket on your chest if you don't pipe the fuck down. But like, I will like if we've taken poops, I'll be like, I need to poop, and like then I'll poop, and I'll be like, I took a terrific poop, and then we high five.
Okay.
Or I'll be like, I need some fucking fiber. That's love.
That's love.
That's love.
That's real.
Getting
too
Dr. Phil here. Yeah. All right, you got a poo story or a poo fear?
No.
Get the fuck out of here.
What?
Okay, we've got a term that we use. You know when you're like, your stomach is just churning, like you need to take a horrendous shit. It's not going to be pretty, it's going to be awful. We call that riding the wave.
Well, because sometimes it gets better.
Because it subsides.
Yes,
it kind of comes in
waves,
and you're just like, you're like, oh my God, I'm going to shit my pants, and it kind of goes down. You're like, I can make it.
Bad, yeah.
And it usually comes back as soon as you're like a block away from your house.
Yeah, it's called riding the wave.
This is
wave.
If I've had
Cowabunga,
a really big...
Cowabunga, listeners.
If I've ever had a really big meal, I know that I can't be any... In a confined space.
Whenever
any
I
other,
like, whenever I'm making
any
breakfast,
living people.
Whenever I'm making breakfast, and I'm like, oh, maybe I'll have sultana bread. I'm like, wait, what am I doing this afternoon? Do I have plans?
I've literally had that, like, I'm two doors down from my house. I'm like, I'm gonna have to drop trow and poo in someone's front. I'm not gonna
let a box.
And then I get home and it's just there's nothing.
You just write like scratch into the poo, dear John.
We also received some of your mail. It was addressed 22, but we got it at number 20. Feel free to come round and pick it up whenever you. And then it just cuts off because I don't have enough poo. That was a lot of poo, though.
Yeah.
That was my message.
Connor, have you got any poop fears or poop stories?
No, I mean, like...
I'm worried people will find out.
I've got a poop war story, but it isn't my own. It's a friend's tale to tell.
Whoa. Can you tell the story?
Yeah.
Yeah, go.
James, this don't is for name you. Them. No, it I'll wasn't name. Him. No, this he is took for the poop. Him. But oh, okay. It was his poop story that he told me, and I was, like, crying.
Yeah.
I won't be able to tell it as well as him.
Just because it's, like, sad. It's
but
like
just so you get... Cancer patients
fault in our shits.
You really reached for that.
What do you mean?
He's like, a fault in our shits.
A fault in our ass. Okay. Yep. So, my friend James and his little brother... What's his little brother's name? I don't know if I can know. Jim. Anyway.
His little brother's name is James. They're just like, okay, next one is James. Go for a streak.
Anyway, James and his little brother had, like, used to just, like, be dickheads to each other, and they, like, spread... Like, shit. James would just go into his little brother's room, pull his pants down, find his room, pull him up, and then leave, right? Go back to his room. And his brother would do the same. And one time... He went into his brother's, into James's room. This is his little brother goes into James's room. He's like, no, I'm going to fart in your room. Pulls his trousers down, spreads his cheeks, farts, and instead of farting, a giant shit leaps across the room. And onto James's bed. And then they're just looking at each other from across the room, like looking at the shit, looking at each other, looking at the shit.
The Kill Bill music playing.
Looking at each other. And they're like, just like, what the fuck do we do? And they're like, whoa, like, running around the shit. And like, their dad gets angry really quickly. And, like, mom,
no,
like,
no. Sounds like he's justified in this. Dad, stop getting so mad. It's just poo all over the shit.
And so they're like, and it's like real late at night, and their dad's just gone to bed. And so they're trying to like get the poop out of the room. And like,
I'm
get
just imagine they like each of them grab one side of the sheet, like on the go to the room, we both pull, and it's like facing the window, like 1, 2, 3, 4, and just like catapults like everywhere across.
So
the
they're
room.
Trying to like get the poop like out of the house,
take an
and
end
kind
of turn each,
yeah, for, like on the duvet, yeah. And they're like kind of like. In the kitchen, like, holding this sheet of poo, like, kind of like, what do we put it? I don't know. And they're kind of just, like, frozen. And, like,
the
like, shh, don't make dad, don't make dad.
Frozen.
And then...
Should've let the poo go.
And then they're, like, making all this ruckus, and they get the poop out of there. And James is in his room spraying Lynx. And then his dad walks in, and they, like, just sit and act cool. And he's like, it smells like, what, like, shit and Lynx. And James like, oh, no, I don't know. I just sprayed deodorant. I don't know why he's smelling shit. And he's like, it smells like shit in here. James is like, no, nobody's shut in here, Dad. That'd be weird. And then like, his dad leaves and he notices there's like spray shit marks on the wall. And to this day, there's like still a stain on his doona.
Oh, that's foul.
I like he didn't get rid of
the doona. Out.
James, you throw the doona out.
Someone shits on the doona. You don't have a doona anymore.
I like
That's the same as anything. Someone shits on your dad, you don't have a dad anymore.
Congrats, you're an orphan.
I like to think in the back of the freezer, to this day, there's still a frozen shit. What do we hold it?
I can't remember what they did with the poop. You told me.
I just told you.
It belongs in a museum.
Dug a hole, buried it in the backyard, and now they got a shit tree.
And made me giggle.
We figured we'd try and pick a less vulgar question of the week.
So, whose relatives' bed sheets have you shat on?
Yeah, I don't know. Do you have any, like... I mean, what's some questions that we've talked about this week that we could... Or what's some topics we've talked about
what's
this week?
What's your stupid, rebellious school act?
Yeah, what's the most rebellious thing you've done in school?
Oh, what's the most rebellious thing you've ever done?
Yeah. Stop.
Yeah.
I don't think... Oh, no, I've done some rebellious shit.
But if it's, like, a serious crime... If you've killed a man...
I've, like, stolen a lip balm from
Coles.
No,
tell us. We'll get you the help you need.
Really?
Bitch.
But then, like, your lips feel good.
Don't you want a bitch like this, huh?
Right.
Like, you lend that lip balm to someone.
Who did?
So, yeah, what's the most rebellious thing you've done in school, outside school? What's, like... And it doesn't have to be, like, genuinely criminal. What's something, I don't know...
Also, what's the least rebellious thing you've ever done?
Yeah, what's something that you thought was really rebellious at the time, but
sometimes
now it's just petty and stupid?
I eat the chocolate chips that are meant for making cookies out of the cupboard.
Yeah.
The mum yells at Lucy and I just let it.
Okay, yeah.
One time I got in an argument with my mum about spaghetti sauce and I just said, fuck it, I made toast instead.
One time at Connor's, I ate the chocolate chips meant for cooking and his mum yelled at Lizzie and I just let her.
One time I was at Connor's and I ate the chocolate chips meant for the cookies.
One time, I don't know why, but my mum started yelling at me about eating chocolate chips and I didn't eat any.
One time, I was at Connor's and I ate the Lizzie and chocolate chips yelled at his mum.
I just let him.
All right, the world just fucking watched.
Okay, this has been the
fourth episode.
A fourth?
Yeah.
Shit, okay, this has been the fourth episode of the Time to Kill podcast. Thanks for listening, if anyone listens.
Thanks, Steve, for sending us in stuff, people.
Yeah. Yeah, thanks, guys.
If you're in a bikey gang, I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
But I think you look so cool.
When you're at Sam's Cafe.
Like, your dick sound huge.
Nothing makes fat, overweight men having midlife crisis look sexier than leather jackets and ill-fitting vests.
I've been Katlin O'Keane.
And you will continue to be Katlin O'Keane.
Until the bike.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
All right, cool. I'm Connor O'Keane.
Oh, Ethan Balls.
Guy. Don't have a last name.
It's like Cher. Yeah, thanks for listening, guys. We'll see you next week.